Hello and welcome back to The Right Part. Today's video is a mishmash, a collage if you may, of various subjects I intended to cover in the previous year, but couldn't dedicate an entire video to. And now since my mod plans have been upended by snail space COVID shipping, I might as well take off a couple of items on my to-do list in the meantime, and use some B-roll I've collected. Don't ask me how, I don't want to talk about it. Unlike the great white shark I previously reviewed, this stingray is quite common, having appeared in two box sets and one easily purchasable polybag should you live in North America. Overall, it is a commendable approximation of a stingray, save for the tail barb which now is so blunt that it's more effective as a rubber punching glove than any sort of stinger. I do understand it's probably for toy safety reasons, however it could be a little bit more pronounced. That aside, the shaping is well done, especially the slight warping towards the pectoral fin's tips. One neat feature I nearly forgot to point out is the minifigure handles molded into the pelvic fins situated beside the tail, right next to the stinger. Is that how divers wait, hold on. And a quick Google search proved, as expected, inconclusive. Series 21 invited controversy with its limited selection of minifigures, although narrowing it down to 12 certainly increased the budget for each, allowing for some standout entries. Namely the Violin Kid, which finally provides us with a violin. Unfortunately, the anatomy of a minifigure prohibits him from holding the violin at the neck, and the placement of the bottom peg is too far away from the minifigure's chin to rest on the chin rest. Neither is the minifigure wand half convincing as a bow, nor is it long enough to contact the strings at reasonable orientations. Thus, the positioning of this character is awkward at best. There are also only 3 strings on the violin, and it's way oversized. But that's ubiquitous among LEGO accessories. Nitpick inside, the mere presence of a violin is welcome, and the shaping does the instrument justice, says the person who held a violin like a ukulele. At the risk of being shouted at by every musician on the planet, the piece works far better as a cello. The size is much more in proportion, and the posture looks far more natural. Yes, the chin rest presence is now very distracted, I don't know how to finish this sentence. Yet, perhaps the standout print of this figure, and let's face it, the piece that elevated it into my top 10 favourites is the face. That expression is perfect for real life me. If I ever make a proper Sig Fig, not my current Raptor Bat hybrid, I'll be sure to use this gloriously sarcastic head. Not that the alternative absorbed music expression is no good, it just pales in comparison to the raised eyebrow. The torso meanwhile is just alright. The green hoodie and white t-shirt is as mundane and generic as can be, perfect for civilian minifigures and for recreating characters from film and TV. Unfortunately, I'll apologize in advance for profaning the entire Blacktron community. The Blacktron logos are terrible as they severely limit reusability. It's nice for LEGO to honor its history, and I'm delighted if you got the reference, but the in-house referencing is a major inconvenience for me personally. Since this video is already off the rails enough, let's just toss in the prosaically named Dragon Suit guy. Celebrating the 40th anniversary of the LEGO minifigure necessitates it to pay homage. The Dragon Suit guy does not disappoint. His design is a tribute to the fantasy era dragon, which is not the most iconic LEGO dragon. However, its design is far more intricate than the classic original. The wings are an inspired reuse, and the tail is spot on. I might complain that the helmet is a bit too tall and wide, though that is a necessary compromise for it to accommodate a minifigure head. Pretty much the only legitimate flaw with this fig is the lack of reusability. How many characters are dying for a set of scaly arms? Yet, that's missing the point, for why would you want to disassemble this cutie? On a separate note, he sports an alternative angry fire-breathing expression. It's a unique, I'll personally stick with the cheery primary smile. It seems only fitting to wrap up a hodgepodge episode with a botched ending. I'm The Right Part, I hope you enjoyed this video, please remember to like-